Hello, welcome back to the Solid State Lectures. Today we start a new chapter, Thermal Properties of Crystals. So we have seen different crystal structures or structures of crystals. Then we have seen the vibration in crystal, that means propagation of energy through crystals. Now our aim is to see that the thermal properties of crystals. The first one is, of course, the heat capacity of the crystals, especially the lattice heat capacity of the crystals or Fonon heat capacity. So you know what is a heat capacity? Heat capacity means it is the heat required to increase the temperature by unity. That means it is the heat required for a unit rise in temperature. The heat capacity means the heat capacity at constant volume, okay, Cv. So that is the partial derivative of the heat energy, total heat energy with respect to the temperature at constant volume. Okay. So we want to find out the total energy, total heat energy of the crystal. What is U? This is the total heat energy of the crystal. So if we have the some energy, U is the energy associated with a particular mode of vibration with the wave vector K and polarization P. Okay, so in the crystals there are different polarization. That is means if the vibration or sound wave is propagating through the medium in a given direction, that means K is the direction of propagation of the energy. To this direction, the vibration in the crystal may be either transverse or longitudinal. There are two transverse polarization, that is vertical vibration and horizontal vibration. So we can resolve all the vibration. There is not only vertical vibration and horizontal vibration. There are vibration in all direction. Okay, atoms may vibrate in all direction. So we can resolve this into two, that is vertical and horizontal. That means it contain all the vibration. So especially there are two polarization mode for each propagation direction as transverse vibration. Okay, and vibration along the direction of propagation. So that is called the longitudinal mode. Okay. So for each mode of vibration, there are three polarization. And U, K, P is the energy associated with a single mode of and a polarization. So therefore, the total energy is of the crystal is sum over all modes. Okay, that means all K values. And sum over all polarization. Then U, K, comma P. Where here K represents what? K represents the propagation vector or the wave vector. Wave vector or of phonons. Phonon. Okay. Now if you find out U, then we have to differentiate with respect to temperature. Actually, what is U, K, O, P? So this also we can find out summation over all K, summation over all P. So U is nothing but the mean occupation number in associated with a particular mode and polarization P, NKP. Average NKP, that is called the mean occupation number. You have studied in the statistical physics, NKP into energy of a particular mode. So H cross omega K. The mean occupation number NK comma P is, we know that E raised to 1 by E raised to h cross omega k comma p by KT. So this K is Boltzmann constant, KBT minus 1. So you have studied. So this is discussed in Kittel. You can see that. I'm not going to discuss this again. We have discussed it in the statistical mechanics class. And you can see another method which is done in the Kittel. So this is the equilibrium mean occupation number. That means occupation number at a constant temperature. That is temperature T. Okay. Now the next one is therefore the total energy U is equal to sum over K and P 1 by H cross omega K BT minus 1 into H cross omega. So this is the total heat energy. Now if the frequencies are very closely spaced, generally the frequencies are very closely spaced. So therefore we can replace this summation by integration. Suppose we have if d of omega is the density of modes or density of states. That means the number of modes per unit of frequency range. Okay. Therefore, d omega is the number of modes in the range omega and omega plus d. For a given polarization, P. The total number of modes within the range d omega, small d omega, is d omega into d of capital D of omega into d omega. That means where d of omega is nothing but the density of state, that is number of modes per unit frequency range dn by d omega. So for the total energy of the given polarization is integral H cross omega K T divided by E raised to H cross omega by KBT minus 1 into B of omega d omega for all the frequencies. Okay, for all the modes. This is for a given polarization P. Now we have to sum over all polarization. So we have reduced our problem to find out this quantity, that is d of omega. So the density of states. We have to find out the density of states. Let us consider a one-dimensional line of length L containing n plus 1 atoms. N plus 1 atoms are there. This is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. This is equal to n. So the total length of the crystal is L. A is the separation between atoms. So in this case, atom S equal to 0 and atom S equal to N are held fixed. So S equal to 0 and S equal to N are held fixed. Okay. Each normal modes of vibration are of the form of standing waves. That means the displacement of the particle U S is equal to U0 exponential minus I omega T into sine S K A. Okay. So here the two N atoms are
stationary. All others are free to move or allowed to move about their mean position. So here, that's why we are using sine sk. Okay. So when at s equal to 0, here the displacement is 0, and s equal to n also displacement is 0. Let us see the case of atom s equal to n, or the particle s equal to n is held fixed. That means the displacement is 0. So therefore, for the displacement us is proportional to sine ska is equal to 0. Therefore, we write Ska is equal to, what is that, n pi, some n pi, or k is equal to n pi by, what is s? So s is equal to, actually s is equal to n. So therefore, n a. So what are the allowed values of k? That means, what are the allowed modes? The allowed modes are with k is equal to, first value is pi by n a. N, what is n a here? We can write this thing as n pi by l. Here n a is equal to the total length of the crystal, that is l. We can write n a is equal to l. So the first allowed value is n is equal to 1, that is pi by l. Next value is 2 pi by l, 3 pi by l, etc. Okay, like that. Up to, there will be k equal to 0, the wave vector k equal to 0 is not allowed, because this is 0 for n atom and also for all other atoms, the displacement of the particle is 0. All other particles also displacement is 0, which is not acceptable. Only n atoms are fixed. So that is at the end of the crystal. So they are fixed, but the inside atoms or inside particles are free to move. Okay. Similarly, k is equal to n pi. N pi by l also not acceptable, because if you substitute when s equal to s is integer anyway, isn't it? Because we are, s is the count of the particle, first one particle, second particle, like that. So here, if we substitute sine s, k is n pi by l into a. This is sine s n pi by l is n a into a. So this is a cancel, n cancel, s pi, sine s pi is equal to sine s pi, which is equal to 0 for all the particles inside, or all the particles inside the crystal is also having 0 displacement, that also not acceptable. So therefore, these two are excluded from this. Okay, therefore, the only allowed values are pi by l, 2 pi by l, 3 pi by l, etc. The final value will be n minus 1 pi by l. So we can say that 1, 2, 3, etc. n minus 1. There are n minus 1 allowed values of k. Okay. So we say that there are n minus 1 modes. Okay. In k space, we can represent this in k space. So this is k equal to 0, this is k equal to pi by a, which is nothing but n pi by l. So the allowed values of k are, this is pi by capital L, 2 pi by l, 3 pi by l, etc. The last final value of the allowed value is n minus 1 pi by L. Okay. So there are n minus 1 allowed values of k, which is exactly equal to the number of particles which are free to move. Okay. So there are n plus 1 particles are there, of that 2 particles are fixed, but remaining n minus 1 particles are free to move. Okay. So therefore we can say that 0 pi by L, pi by L to 2 pi by L, there is only one mode. Therefore each interval delta k is equal to pi by L, there is one mode. Okay, one mode per pi by L range of wave vector is there. One mode in each pi by L. Okay, therefore L by pi is the number of modes per unit range of k. Per unit range of k. But we know the density of states. What is density of states? D of omega is equal to dn by d omega. Okay. Which is equal to dn by dk into dk by d omega. Okay. So this is equal to dn by dk is L by pi. Number of mods per unit range of k, that is L by pi. This is L by pi and this dk by d omega. So you know what is d omega by dk. D omega by dk is equal to the group velocity. So this is therefore L by into 1 by v. Okay. So this is actually the density of states in one dimension. Okay. So this is one method. This is done by using a fixed boundary condition. Now we can see this same thing in a periodic boundary condition. The periodic boundary condition case we will see later. Okay.